So now we are going to see the technique to find the square of a number, of course, which is near to some numbers like 1000, 100 or 10,000 kind of numbers. So the rule says like this: lessen the number to the extent of deficiency and put the square of the deficiency, or increase the number to the extent it exceeds and put the square of it. So taking the first thing, let's find out square of a number and we'll say how it is applicable. So let's take the case of 93. So 93 is 7 less than 100. So to find out the square, the rule says lessen the number to the extent of the deficiency. Deficiency from the base. So base here is 100, so the deficiency is 7. So again less the number by the deficiency. So 93 minus 7, how much it comes to? 86. And then put the square of the deficiency. Deficiency is 7, put the square of it. That is 49. 7 square 49. That's all is the answer. Let's check out with calculator. 93 into 93, 8649. That's all is the answer. So let's take one more example to check this out. For the case of, let's say, 89 square. So lessen the number by the extent of deficiency. So it is deficient by 11 than 100. So again we will do a deficient, again we will subtract it by 11. So 89 minus 11, which gives 78, and deficiency is 11. 11 square is 121. We can only accommodate two numbers here, so we write 21 here and 1 here. So the answer is 7921. Let's check the answer. Eighty-nine into 89, 7921. So that's all is the answer. So let's check out a bigger number also in this case. That is 989 square. So in this case, our base is 1000. So how much is less 989 by 1000? That is 11. So lessen it by again by 11. So that gives me 978. And then put the square of the deficiency. Deficiency 11. Put the square. That is 121. In this case, I'll put 121 because our base is 1000. So we can keep three numbers here. So that's all is the answer. 7, 9, 8, 9, 7, 8, 1, 2, 1. Let's check out. 989 into 989, 9, 7, 8, 1, 2, 1. So you can just imagine that with a single line we are able to write the answer of this. So how effective it is. Let's find out something for a bigger, for a number which is more. Consider the case of 109 square. So here the second part of the rules comes into picture. Increase the number to the extents. Increase the number to the extent it exceeds the base. It exceeds the base, which is 100 by 9. So increase it by that base. That is 109 plus 9. So it becomes 118. And then put the square of it, the increased part, which is 9. So 81 is the square. So answer is 11881. Let's check out. So answer is 11881. That's all. So in this way you can solve any of the questions that comes like this. So you can know that where it applies, so accordingly you can solve it. So let's now find out what is the trick behind it. How do it work? So again, it's same simple trick. You'll be amazed to see this. So here, what we are doing is, we know a square minus b square is equal to a plus b into a minus b. Therefore, we can write a square is equal to a plus b whole into a minus b plus b square. And the same principle we are applying. Just check out the example we have given. 989 square, I can write in the above form as 989 plus 11 and 989 minus 11 plus 11 square. So here 989 plus 11 gives me the number 1000, and 989 minus 11 gives me 978. So I multiply 978 into 1000, which gives me 978 three zeros, and then I put 121, so it becomes 978121. That's all. It is quite simple actually. To understand it is quite simple. While we look at, we feel that okay, there should be some very big science behind it, but actually it is not. It is the small things that we miss to absorb. Once we observe it, we can really find what's how it can be done. So that's all about it. So finding square of a number near to any bigger number of 1000, 100, 10,000, you can apply the same principle and just write the answers in the single line. So that's all from this lecture. Let's meet on the next lecture to discuss some more tricks. Thank you.